They will be different but the same. Yeah, it looks good. So I guess I'm having pink doves. But I could see these in different colors. This is one of those images that I could see in shades of blue, shades of gray, shades of green, shades of red. So if you, before you start this, which maybe you already have, but if you get the instant download, just print a few of them and do them in different colors. And that is a way that you could use them, like if you wanted to have three in a set. You could, and they'd each be a little bit different. So I could see doing this image in lots of different colors. I really like it. It's simple. Sometimes the most beautiful things are really simple. This is a pretty purple. I'm going to go with this. Let's go on the inside of this circle. Now this is not a watercolor, but these pencils do blend. Not the same, but more than they did in the last segment. I like these colors. I think I'm going to let that color go. Now this is a watercolor violet. Alright, and then I want these to mirror each other, but again, I don't want them to feel, I don't want them to be exactly the same. But I want them to be balanced. So I'm going to bring that color down to this one. Okay, let's see what other colors we got here. That's a nice color. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the doves in this color, finish it off. And this is one of those colors that does blend. It's a watercolor. But I have to be a little careful. So I shall. So yeah, this picture is about focus. Unity and focus. I like this blue. It's not quite, it's kind of got a little gray in it. It's pretty. Almost feels purpley too. It's an interesting color. So I think it is a good choice for our doves. For any really dark color. I like that color. I think I'm going to make this the inside background color. This is not a watercolor pencil. But I mix them, you can see that. Because when I do use the watercolor pencils with non-watercolor pencils, the colors do blend. And some more so than others, and these are the ones that do blend more so than the other coloring pencils. Well, there's a little mark right there that you don't have on yours, but again, I don't worry about it. It was a pen mark, and couldn't erase it, so there it is, and it's okay. Yeah, and I'm going to go over this color, but that's a nice base. I don't want my colors muddy, so I am being careful, and I'm going around these little pink dots because I want them to maintain their color. That's looking good so far. Okay, and let's see what else we got. This is a watercolor green, and I'm gonna go over it with this green, and I'm a little heavier handed with it because I know it's watercolor and it will blend beautifully. And it doesn't even have to be, when you know it's a watercolor that is going to blend, you don't have to be as careful. Now, you don't want to get crazy and do all kinds of scribble scrabble, unless that's the look you're going for, and that's just fine. But if you don't want it to be rough textured, you can use a heavier hand, but still keep the brush strokes going in the same direction. Okay, I like that. See, that added depth right there, just that extra green. And I think I'm going to add another green. This is apple green.